Come help us celebrate the spirit of Texas on air.
We start out tonight close enough to home, about 50 miles south of Fort Worth in Cleburne, but we're going on a road trip with a group of kids from Cleburne High School, most of whom have never traveled farther than a state band competition. But they're about to get the chance of a lifetime, the chance to meet another group of folks who, in a lot of ways, might have you thinking backwards, because that's the way things are 10,000 miles from home, on the opposite side of the planet, on the other side of the equator, in the great down under, in Australia.
To you by the friendly folks in DQ Country, Dairy Queen.
Let's go, Jackets! Let's go, Jackets! Let's go,
Texas, it's the hottest ticket around. The boys over at the high school are local heroes. But here in Cleburne, it's not just the action on the gridiron the fans come to see. It's the Cleburne High School Golden Pride Band.
They've been called the best little high school band in the state. The big, bold sound from the small Texas town, Cleburne, Texas, where halftime means showtime. Golden Pride stretched for more than 50 yards. When a school has a band this good, it usually doesn't take long for word to get around. It's just not very often word gets all the way around the world. From the practice field in Cleburne to the state marching contest in Austin, word was out. Dick Helmkamp's band was one of the best Texas had to offer. It was at that state marching contest when a representative of the Australian government first saw this band, a high school band like none he had seen before, a band he invited to represent Texas at Expo 88 in Brisbane, Australia, to travel nearly 10,000 miles to show off in the land down under, to be official goodwill ambassadors for the Lone Star State.
Well, I called everybody together and told them about the invitation. And then, you know, after we scraped them off the ceiling, they calmed down a little bit and we were able to talk about it. Yeah, they were really excited.
Fact is, the whole town of Cleburne got so excited about this trip to the land of Oz that getting the band there became a community project. As you can imagine, a trip to Australia just wasn't in the school's yearly budget. So every band member had to raise the money to pay their own way. Businesses offered the kids extra jobs. There were bake sales, car washes, and donations from folks who just wanted to help.
That's cool. That's really
cool. Yeah.
After the money was raised, all that was left was the hours of rehearsal and the days of waiting. Waiting and wonderment of a faraway land from a group of kids in which few had ever been out of the state of Texas.
It's probably going to be like a whole different from Texas and everything.
Let them know we're not total hicks.
Well, don't wear a cowboy
hat.
They're probably just as excited to see us as we are to see them.
Just to get different, you know,
culture. Yeah. We're going to be like sitting there, you talk, I want to hear you talk. No, I want to hear you talk.
Please, just say something.
We'll go on that trip down under, maybe even teach the natives to say, good day, y'all. Stay with us.